it away, and Derbyshire win. First time they have won this Benson and Hedges competition.
Derbyshire and Lancashire, then, last year's finalists, meet at Derby in this year's round two of the Benson and Hedges Cup competition. Welcome to the highlights of that match. We've been at Derby, and remember, around the country there have been 16 other sides keenly looking forward to the competition, hoping one day, I suppose, to appear in the Lord's final, where they would take away the cup, and of course £31,000 of Benson and Hedges prize money. It's been a blustery, sunny day at Derby. I was out there at the start with the captains for the toss and a quick chat with them.
Morning, gentlemen. Azza, did you win the toss?
Yeah, I won the toss. Yeah, we're bowling.
What's the pitch like? What are the conditions like?
It's quite good. It's got a little bit of green on that. You know, it might, whatever it will do, it might do in the beginning and in the morning. But I think it's a pretty flat wicket. You know, I mean, we're looking forward to a very good game, and I hope both the teams play to the best of their ability and play to the potential and give a lot of, whatever you may call it. You know, I mean, a lot of.
What about entertainment?
Good to the team, yeah, entertainment,
I'm worried about you, you know, but here you are captain in a county. It's hard enough to captain a test team, but did you volunteer for this job when poor old Kim had to withdraw?
Oh, well, that's right. You know, I thought I would get away from the captaincy for another 5 or 6 months, but I've got to do it now, so I'm prepared for it now.
Good luck, anyway.
Yeah, thank you.
Mike, you've got some rather serious injury problems.
Yes, unfortunately, we lost Wasim Akram and Neil Fairbrother during the weekend with hamstring injuries, so we're without their services today. So that was a bit of a blow to the side, obviously.
Who's playing instead?
Well, we've got Nick Speak, who's coming in from the side which played on Sunday, and we've got Glenn Chappell, seam bowling department, to cover for Wasim. So hopefully we can get by without the services.
This is a rerun of last year's final.
It is, yeah. It's a bit of an earlier round. It's a cooler day as well, I think. But hopefully we can have a Lancashire victory on this one.
Good luck to you both.
Thank you very much.
So Azza Rahdeen expecting there a good pitch, plenty of runs to chase. In his side, of course, without Kim Barnett, the captain, who has a cartilage operation at the weekend, he takes over the leadership, but plenty of all-round bowling there. With Philip de Freitas, who was in Lancashire's final side last year, this time appearing for Derbyshire. And Lancashire, without Neil Fairbrother and Wasim Akram, you must really agree, are one-day specialists, and they probably will miss them very badly indeed. The umpires, with Nigel Plews, Ken Palmer, both extremely experienced. Derbyshire won the toss, let me remind you, and will field. Let's join them now with a second ball. De Freitas, who had 3 wickets in that final last year, runs in this time to bowl for Derbyshire to Jason Gallion.
Oh, dropped him. Second ball of the innings, and the catch goes down at second slip.
This ball here from De Freitas to Gallion, turned him inside out, gone high to Azza Rahdeen at second slip. Derbyshire may rue that drop chance.
That's a very good shot, clipped off the toes there. Big chase in the outfield and the ball not carrying, so 4 runs run. That's a good shot. That's typical Atherton, letting the ball come onto the pads and then flicking it away through mid-wicket, 4 runs.
Super shot from Michael Atherton, just letting the ball come on, steering it in front of square all on the floor. 4 runs.
Cracking shot, wonderful shot. He had the width, the ball was well up, it's swinging away. But Jason Gallion really bent the front knee into that.
That's a glorious shot. You can see Jason Gallion's left foot go out to the pitch, hands through the ball, nice and high elbow, left elbow, and that scream through extra cover. Super strike. A looks a pretty good pitch to me. There's a fair amount of grass though on it. A little bit, if I had a look at it earlier on and scuffed it up with my foot, and there's some juicy green grass there, which I expect the opening bowlers, especially in the first hour, to get a fair amount of lateral movement. In fact, we've seen that already.
Everyone running vital in this 55 overs a side match, and the prize is big, of course. The Benston Hedges is still the knockout format, sudden death, but next year it'll revert to a league basis in the earlier stages. Well bowled, beautifully bowled. You hear the groans go up as the ball finds the inside edge of Atherton's bat, goes down to fine leg, squirts past the off stump for two runs.
Paul Mortensen's been probing away outside off stump, getting the ball to go away from the right hander, and this one has bounced. Mike Atherton pushing a little bit hard at it. He's got an inside edge outside the stumps and beating the keeper. It's a good shot if you can perfect it.
Good shout. Oh, that was close. Very close indeed. Mike Atherton not making great ground with his front pad. Or front foot.
Well, he's not come an awful long way forward here. I think he's just got outside the line though. Just freshly outside the line of off stump. The ball nipping back to him.
I would think that Philip de Freitas might be trying a bit today.
Yes, there's a bit of a personal feud, friendly feud, between him and Michael Atherton. Might not be too friendly at the moment. Certainly trying.
And Atherton wins that one. Beaten one ball, handsome cover drive the next. Three runs in this.
Their first bowling change. Dominic Cork, who toured South Africa with the England A side and then had to come home a shade early because of family bereavement. Also played so well in that final last year. Well, a little bit of a loosener, slow outfield, and this time the ball will win. Fourth four of the morning, umpire Nigel Plews.
Method of supposedly stopping the ball has just proven to have a risk. A lot of fielders nowadays like to slide to the ball at the last moment and position themselves to spring up from the slide and throw the ball, but if you flick it back onto the bottom hand, you end up in that sort of trouble.
Three bowlers used so far. Good spell from De Freitas and Mortensen. Bit a better looking shot than that. Against that, if you get a simple straightforward half volley, that's what it deserves. Oh, well bowled. Now that's the one, perfectly pitched, perfect line. Only thing is, it missed the edge.
That's the ultimate frustration, of course. You get everything absolutely right as the bowler. There was absolutely nothing Jason Gallion could do. He certainly couldn't get an edge on it. Beautiful delivery, really too good.
Oh, that was squared him up. And again, we'll see that Mike Atherton, when he gets into a defensive shot almost across his crease, he tends to get square on. When he does, then there's problems.
This ball kept a little bit low as well, but the bat comes across the line of the ball in an effort to make the right contact.
That was a little wide, actually, to push at defensively, but that is where the virtue of bowling close to the stumps sometimes gets reward. Beautifully timed. That's the problem for an outswing bowler. He's trying to get that swing towards slip going and pushing it the odd one leg side.
This, unfortunately, it's very costly when it goes wrong.
That's a good shot. Nobody need move for that. In the air, but be away for another boundary.
A lot of outside edge in this shot, just clearing Azharuddin in a deep gully position.
Brilliant piece of fielding there, and the first wicket goes down, not due to the bowlers, but due to some brilliant fielding there. Bowler has gone away to his right, gathered it in. Gallien has been down the track. Atherton didn't respond. That's great work.
There's not very good communication, I'm afraid, between the batsmen. In the end, Jason Gallien, you won't see him in that frame, I promise you. Carl Cricken showing, shall we say, some of the frustration that Derbyshire have felt at not taking the wicket earlier in the day. Knocking the stump out of the ground slightly ungallantly.
86 for one at the moment. 39 to Gallien, who played very well out there. Looks a very well-organised young player. And the running between the wickets of the pair up to that moment had been very good. John Crawley is the new man. Dominic Cork has done it again. He's gone past the outside edge on several occasions out there. Michael Atherton has been on the receiving end of the earlier ones. Paul Allard is back in the commentary box with us now.
Again, that's a pretty good delivery to get first up.
It's a very strange thing that's going on out there with Colin Wells and with Mohammad Azharuddin, the skipper, who's placing the field. They're five on the offside, four on the on. Not a ball's being bowled on the offside. It's a good-looking stroke, and the execution of it was quite interesting. I sat back and watched Michael Atherton from the back of the commentary box this morning. The first thing that struck me, first ball he faced, was that he's made a slight change in his stance. And certainly he's making an initial movement, only a very slight movement, with his front foot towards cover or extra cover. Maybe something that has happened after or during the West Indies tour. Crawley comes with a big rap. Quite a bit of that rap comes from English cricket followers, but also from the Australian team when they toured last year, when they were asked to pinpoint the player they thought most impressive with the bat, and they came up against in all their county games. John Crawley was the man they chose. There was a shout there from the bowler. They consider that to be ill luck, but the fielder had to go from deep backward square way down to deep fine leg. I won't say that Mohammad Azharuddin is tearing his hair out at the moment. He's quite a calm character, but he's not going to be very happy with that. half century for Michael Atherton. He's played very well. Had a certain amount of assistance from the bowlers with their, and in particular their line. Very good stroke. De Freitas is not slow across the outfield. Good performance. Well, the bowlers have suffered a little here today. Derbyshire put Lancashire into bat. De Freitas bowled very well early on. Then Mortensen had 28 taken from six overs. Cork 24 from six. Didn't bowl badly, Dominic Cork. Kept going past the outside edge for no result. Wells none for 42 from 8, and Warner 19 taken off 3. 61 off 11 overs from the two bottom bowlers there, and that's a real problem for Derbyshire.
Lucky but no slip, so can't be any complaints.
Well, that's always the frustration for any bowler in one day cricket. The slips disappear, the edge comes, would have gone straight to where the orthodox first slip was standing. Instead, of course, it's four runs.
Mortensen now, he's bowling to Atherton. The 150 up. It's coming the 34th over. It is a tremendous start. Beautifully bowled. Every now and again there's something there, and that'll encourage Lancashire as well as Derbyshire. Runs are on the board.
That ball was actually quite wide by the time Mike Atherton decided to play at it. Nicely bowled there, a little bit of swing, and the line of the ball carrying on with the swing away from the outside edge of the bat.
Philip De Freitas back, pick of the attack this morning. His worst ball of the morning.
Well, Philip De Freitas started the day very well, as Jack was saying, and looked as though he had a mission in mind. Well, with some good pace and what is a slowish pitch, well, this was just a loosener. Sat up nicely for John Crawley, plenty of width outside the off stump, and you can judge the pace of the pitch there by the way he's hit that away through extra cover rather than square of the wicket.
Four more. 14th boundary of the innings, and that's been Derbyshire's problem in this pre-lunch session. Too many bad balls.
But beautifully placed by Mike Atherton, and nicely timed too. Straight back down the ground. Again, no real effort involved in that shot, just pure timing.
Close. Five Plews got into a good position, but this must have been close.
See Nigel Plews setting off there, and he's got his head looking back over his shoulder there as this ball comes in. The bat comes down just a fraction too late. So whatever position Nigel Plews got into might not have been quite good enough. A bit of an escape there for John Crawley. That's been another feature of Lancashire's innings as well today, apart from the run out that caused the dismissal of Jason Gallen, and of course another close shave for John Crawley. They've been keen to look with his quick singles. Apart from those two main and sole examples, they've generally judged them pretty well.
It's one of the better shots of the morning. Slower ball from Dominic Cope. And John Crawley gave it plenty.
Certainly made very good contact. It's not always easy to time the slower ball.
That's a very good performance by Lancashire. 200 up, and Atherton and John Crawley in complete charge here. Well, that's a very good stroke. Colin Wells was the weak link early on. He was very expensive. He couldn't get his line right. He was down the leg side all the time. He was again in that instance. And John Crawley has brought up a very good half century with that shot. That's the 100, and applause round this ground for Michael Atherton. Played very well. Good performance. Nice partnership, first of all, with Jason Gallien and now with John Crawley.
Yes, it's been a very good, steady innings, this. But in many ways, surprisingly quick. 100 off 149 balls.
Beautiful. Beautiful wicket-keeping. And the wide is given, but not a problem there. Atherton will still go on the long march. Tricken is one of the more energetic wicket-keepers you will ever see. And he's done a great job there.
Well, you can see how wide down the leg side that ball went. It's a very, very good take indeed by Carl Cricken. Mike Atherton really nowhere near the ball at all. That was just a little bit of swing which helped it drift further down the leg side. But a very fine innings comes to a very quick end after the 100. Statistics now 100 off 150 balls. And that's a very good rate of scoring for an opening batsman in this form of cricket. Exactly the sort of innings on which you can base a proper total.
Election of the Lancashire balcony there, David Lloyd, Bob Bennett and Mike Atherton.
Again, they're bowling in the right area. Oh, a chapter of accidents and incidents and in the end, some fairly poor cricket all the way around. No run. The bells weren't disturbed.
Well, the best thing about this was the delivery, fired in at the pads. Graham Lloyd got an inside edge onto the pads, no calling, scrabbling around Alan Warner for the ball. Bowled him. That's bowled him off pad and instep. The ball that was fired way, way down the leg side. Good piece of bowling by Alan Warner. And that would, if Graham Lloyd had stepped inside that, I'm sure that would have been given a wide, but he's trying to get outside the line, hit it through the offside, and all it's done, just fired it in, look at that, way down leg side, and then just clipped the top of off stump. That's very unfortunate for Graham Lloyd. But good bowling by Alan Warner, renowned.
I think the match situation will be bothering David a bit. The 200, remember, came up in the 43rd over, and here we are 8 overs later, 238. Wickets don't matter, but 38 runs in 8 overs, Paul, at this stage of the innings, it's not what Lancashire won. Well, done him round his legs. So the end of a very, very good innings by Crawley, and all credit to Warner. He's mixed it up, he's bowled intelligently, he's bowled a full length, and he's got a wicket.
Again, it's perfect bowling this stage of the game. fired in, pitching almost in the block hole, right at leg stump. John Crawley getting over to the offside to try and work it down to fine leg. The vacant area behind square. But a fine innings by John. 73 runs.
Bowled, well bowled indeed. Full perfect Yorker. So Dominic Cork gets a wicket for what that matters. What's more important, no run off the delivery.
Well, again, it's the ideal delivery. Dominic Cork getting in close to the stumps, just swinging that ball back into Nick Speak. Perfect. Block hole, leg stump.
A further 12 runs were added after Nick Speak's wicket fell, and 280 for 5 was the final score of the Lancashire innings. The pillar of the innings, without doubt, Michael Atherton's century, scored in excellent style, and a fine stumping too to remove him, and Crawley, I thought, played well in partnership. They put on 131 together. Derbyshire's bowling was loose at the start, even though the ball swung about a bit and moved, but it was pulled together by Warner mainly at the end. Two wickets came to him. 57 runs conceded off 11 overs, and De Freitas, of course, always accurate in this form of cricket, 0-44 off 11. So now then, Derbyshire required 281 runs to win the match at 5.10 runs per over. Let's join them now in the fourth over. Chappell bowls to Rollins. 5 runs are on the board.
And that was a pretty good stroke. Martin has struck. That's a very good wicket. Looks impressive. Peter Martin, I was trying to work out where we saw him. It was a game between Lancashire and Surrey last year where he bowled in lively fashion on a very good oval pitch where there was plenty of bounce. And he slipped one through the defence of Peter Bowler there. LBW without scoring.
And Derbyshire have lost their first wicket for 12.
He wouldn't believe it. He simply wouldn't believe it. All I can say is that it has come far too slowly for him. He won't be able to work out precisely what happened. Jonathan Crawley, the man who's put one down there.
I think he'll say, actually, he'll be able to live, he'll be able to sleep tonight, because I think that ball actually came off the forearm as opposed to the glove. Have another look at that. Very hard to tell. It might have been glove, might have been forearm, as Chris Adams was looking to leave that ball alone. It's a very good over in progress here from Peter Martin. This is the one in question. It looks to me there, that's hit him on the forearm, just below the elbow, actually.
Well, that's one of the better overs you'll see this summer. That was a very, very good ball. Deserved better than to have a single taken off it. Turned the batsman around, infused him with a swing, just found a thickish outside edge.
Very much one of these bowlers, Peter Martin, who relies on good rhythm. The rhythm goes, so does the pace.
Safely away through gully. There is a man down on the boundary, Ian Austin, but he's got no chance. Any fast bowler worth his salt will be displeased by that.
nothing else he can do about it because that's the end of the over. But it was well bowled again. It was the one that goes away, the away swinger.
Whoa, well bowled again. Beautiful movement, committing the batsman to the forward stroke and just grazing past the outside edge.
Superb delivery from Peter Martin, just beating the outside edge. Pitching in line with Ostump, swinging slightly and just carrying on off the seam.
Good shot. One of the rare balls that's been just over-pitched by Martin.
Just slightly over-pitched by Peter Martin. Crunching, thumping off drive, not much top hand in it, bottom hand came through into it quite predominantly.
Oh, that's a good shot. He got into a beautiful position then on the back foot, really waited for the ball and picked the gap through extra cover. 4 runs to Rollins.
Rocks onto the back foot here, there's Adrian Rollins, and powers that through the offside. He really has given that a thump.
And another one. 2-2 balls off the back foot, very strong with the bottom hand, as you've heard Paul Allett describe, but also very good judgment, waiting on the back foot, bringing that bottom hand to play.
Again, a bit of width from Glenn Chappell, just short as well. He seized on that. Hardly any foot movement at all, but he's just swung that bat through the line.
Another good shot off the back foot by Adrian Rollins. Now he's played 3 cracking shots, all for 4, off the back foot, within the last 2 overs.
Glorious shot by Chris Adams. It's finally come right for him, aided and abetted by a loose delivery from Mike Watkinson. There it comes wide. Adams on the front foot and crashed it through extra cover. A good shot from young Adrian Rollins there. All he's done is lent on that. You see, again, not a great deal of foot movement, but he stayed in line. His left elbow was high that time. Nothing really more than a defensive push.
It's a super shot. I haven't seen anything of Rollins before today, Paul. I don't know about you, but he stands up and my word, he whacks it.
That's a super shot that he's just played there. Again, it's played with a minimum of effort.
In the air, but it's hit hard. And look for 2. Oh, get more than that. My word, that was an untidy piece of fielding. And they've run 4. Basic error. Make sure you pick it up before you try to throw it.
Sloppy stuff there from Jason Gallion. I think he'd have been trying to... Rollins laying that through to deep extra cover. Cardinal error, really, going down with one hand. There'd have been 2 hands in the hands and get it back in over the stumps.
Wonderful, wonderful stuff. It really was one of the best drives you've seen all day. It wasn't a half volley. It wasn't a really hard hit. It was timing, it was a firm push, and it was played with a full face of the bat. 11 fours for Derbyshire so far. Rollins has hit 10 of them. That's 50. Super innings. Well, one or two good judges raved about him to me towards the end of last season. I didn't know what I was going to see, but it's very impressive. Catch. He was going the wrong way. I have a feeling he thought it was going to come faster, then slipped a little bit, and the England captain has finally dived forward and slightly sideways and taken the catch that's sent Adrian Rollins back to the pavilion. That's a good wicket for Lancashire.
Good wicket and well deserved for Glenn Chappell. His ball very straight since changing ends. The racecourse stand end there might have just stopped on him. A good diving catch from Mike Latherton. Difficult one to judge. Probably thought it was coming a bit quicker. Benefits of bowling straight from Glenn Chappell there. So that's just nipped back into Rollins. Mike Latherton taking a good diving low catch. Good innings from the young man.
Mohammad Azharuddin captaining Derbyshire today, and a big task in front of him. It's a wicket maiden, and a very, very good performance.
Well bowled by Glenn Chappell there. That's, you can see that ball just deviating slightly. Azharuddin playing a flat-footed waft at that.
Good catch again. He took a neat diving catch a little earlier, and that one was hit with fierce power by Azharuddin, and that's the one they wanted. No doubt about the enjoyment there, and I suspect it stung just a fraction.
Well, that was hit with tremendous power, and you can see from all the reaction there, the Lancashire players delighted to dismiss Mohammad Azharuddin. Here it is, Gary Yates. Seeing him coming, flighted it. That's hit. That's nearly knocked Mike Atherton off his feet. Good catch. Made it look very simple. Caught under his chin. Still going up. Tim O'Gorman, the next Derbyshire batsman.
Tim O'Gorman.
Well, that's as easy as you'll see. Sort of thing can happen when you're intent on pushing the score along. Gary Yates has done well. He's had a good spell of bowling in keeping with the general way in which Lancashire performed out there. Good bowling from Martin, from Chappell, and now from Yates.
See this dismissal again. Gary Yates on leg stump. Ball going straight on with the arm and the leading edge. Straight back to him, and he's delighted. He's bowled well. Kept flighting the ball, Gary Yates, even though he went for 13 runs off his first two overs. Come in commendably well. Up to bowling leg stump.
Colin Wells is the new batsman.
That's in the air and in space. That's a long hit out there. There's a lot of field out there. It's the longest boundary on the field, and he picked his spot perfectly.
When you said it was in space, I thought you meant it had gone a lot, lot further.
And that's a better shot. The ball wasn't quite so far up. Wells came down the pitch to meet it, and that's four runs. And Derbyshire, taking five off the over, need to do all that and a little bit more.
Well, he wasn't quite there, Colin Wells, but the one thing he did well was to get it dead straight down the ground.
Very explosive shot from Tim O'Gorman. He's given himself a bit of room. The left leg's gone down, leg stump rather than to the pitch of the ball. Pitch early on this morning wasn't conducive for stroke play, but expansive stroke play anyway.
Well, one or two big overs, that's what Derbyshire need, and this one is starting to take shape for them.
Disciplined bowling is what Lancashire need still, and that's not from Mike Watkinson. Hammered in halfway down. O'Gorman's gone for the big one again, top edge.
It was well played, there was no pace on the ball, got two, forced an error and got a third. So off a delivery which, had he hit it harder, would only have produced a single, he's ended up with three.
That's poor fielding again from Lancashire. One-handed swoop, he's not got down to that. Looking to throw it in before he's got the ball in the hand. It's getting towards the time for Yorkers.
Like that, well nominated by Paul Allett, and Ian Austin does it again.
Just what's required there by Ian Austin. Full length, pitching in the block hole. See that all the way from the bowler's hand. There it is, right on the block hole, off stump. There's no way you can hit those for anything other than one. Dig them out and hope to get one. Unfortunately, Tim O'Gorman has played over the top of that. Philip De Freitas, the incoming batsman. The point to prove to his old Lancashire colleagues.
Out or not out? Not out. Just clearing him. Well, it's got to be desperate stroke play because there's no way that normal cricket can get 100 off 10 overs. Got to improvise, you've got to dart this way and that way and then hope the luck goes with you like that. And when you get one pitched up, you can do that. It was a good shot.
Even though Derbyshire need 10 and over, it's still not without away from their grasp. Colin Wells giving that the full treatment over wide mid-off.
Gone. Made all the room in the world to hit it offside. Got a bottom or inside edge and Hegg did the rest. De Freitas goes. And that must nearly be the end for Derbyshire.
The sad-looking Philip De Freitas on the way out. Good bowling from Glenn Chappell. He saw De Freitas going away and followed him a little bit. That's gone through with some pace on it. Looking at Warren Hegg, that's taken that. Still going up, chest height. Bit of zip in that, bit of extra bounce. Well bowled, well taken by Warren Hegg.
Dominic Cork next in, and remember what a super innings he played in the final at Lord's last July. It's in the middle. It's a big boundary, but it'll get there.
Jason Gallion not learning here at all. Halfway down, he can be hit on either side of the wicket. Dominic Cork getting a free swing at that.
There's four more. And exactly what Paul Allop was saying. If you pitch it down there, you give the batsman either side something of a hit. That brings up the 200. Lancashire's 200 came up in the 43rd over.
That's just asking to be hit wide and short. Dominic Cork obliges.
Safe or not? It is. Did he get a touch on it? Yes, he did. Ten off the first four deliveries.
And Dominic Cork going for the big hit. Warren Egg realising there's no chance of getting that. Ian Austin circumnavigating it.
Well, I don't think they'll get that. My first impression was it came off the pad. Perhaps it hit the bat as well.
It was certainly a brilliant take. My first impression was they were appealing for LBW. But I might change that. Brilliant take by Warren Haig, diving away to his right. And that's must have come off bat. It hasn't been signalled a leg by as such, but let's have another quick look at that. Could have come off the back pad, but my initial impression from the first two replays was it had come off the outside edge of the bat.
That a little touch of pressure perhaps. I think it would be not the way the game's placed, but you never know.
I'm gonna say it's lucky it's not really close. There's no real excuse for that at all. Nick Speak tries to get everything behind it. It can only be just a blink of the eye at the last moment. He's got every right to be quite embarrassed.
And there's four. Well, that's one of them. Got to take three in and over at this stage.
Well, at least the shuffle worked this time. Outside the leg stump, back in front of the stumps, and a good, clean, thick edge. Fine of the long leg man, that's the key.
Man, a deep square, but can't get it now. That suddenly becomes a good over. Good over for Derbyshire. Colin Wells has got that wide of the man at deep square. That too much. Just a little spray onto the leg side, and this is good cricket from Dominic Cork. Also from Colin Wells.
Well, Dominic Cork gets himself into a good position here by advancing down outside off stump. He took that ball from 6 inches, 9 inches wide of off stump.
Could be a good catch. There's pressure again. Gary Yates, the off-spinner, who bowled pretty well early on. Now Lancashire have got to pull themselves together. They're in trouble.
Same thing again. Dominic Cork looking for the space, premeditated. Gary Yates came in about 15, 20 yards and did everything right until the end.
Good shot for Cork.
Well, that's the difference between the Yorker and the full toss. Very well struck by Dominic Cork, because he managed to get it over, directly over Mike Watkinson at extra cover.
Very, very good stroke. Maybe a bit more pressure on the fielding side. Mike Watkinson, the skipper, maybe thinking at the moment, but he will have to bowl the last over. That's a good shot. Risky, but doesn't matter. Got to do it. He's done it again. In fact, they have done it again. Austin has bowled the full pitch, and Cork has smashed it away behind square leg for six. Wonderful hit.
Well, the great thing about this shot is just beautifully timed. A little bit of top edge in it. But he's got in exactly the same position again. Ian Austin has tried to compensate, tried to bowl that foot, foot and a half further up, and he's got it too far up.
When unlucky. Versatile and imaginative, but unlucky. Dominic Cork has made 50 in 32 balls. It has been brilliant to watch.
So, Dominic Cork has the reverse sweep available again, as he had to the last ball of Ian Austin's over.
Bob ball. Well, third man is up inside that circle. He's a man out at deep point. He's going to cut it off. Let's get the two. He'll be content to have Dominic Cork retain the strike. So it's now nine from four balls. That is difficult, but it'll put a new complexion on if Dominic Cork can hit a boundary. And that field is going to cut off again. They'll still get two. They must score off everything. That's why the first ball, where he tried the reverse sweep, is likely to be a bit of a problem, but it's seven from three at the moment. Still need a boundary very, very badly. Get it down to three from two. Wonderful stroke from Dominic Cork, and his batting partner Colin Weld was down there into his ear before the ball even hit the boundary.
Well, he's certainly been practicing this shot, and it's working very well for him. Great thing is there, he keeps his eyes on the ball. It's what you might call a controlled slog. He's preempted the bowler yet again. If you make good contact like that, there's plenty of space to play with. The man at square leg is very square, the man at long leg at about 45 degrees.
Well, it is a great effort. A wonderful shot. He's finished it with a six. Dominic Cork is the hero. There are plenty of them around. But Dominic Cork is the one of the moment. That is a sensational victory for Derbyshire. They put Lancashire in the bat, they chased an enormous total, and they got there in the final over with just one ball to spare.
Well, again, the margin was just inches, wasn't it? Just out at deep square leg there, that shot went straight over John Crawley, who'd taken a step or two in from the boundary. There'll be some very long faces going back into that Lancashire dressing room now. They've let it slip, very definitely let it slip. But full credit to Dominic Cork.
So there we see it. Derbyshire win by four wickets. Who would have thought it? Just one ball to spare. 284 for six. And there was no doubt about it that the gold award should be presented to Dominic Cork for his 64 not out. And that included...
All of us in Norwich, good night.
I only feel alive when I'm acting upon the stage.
On Tuesday, Omnibus profiles an actor who has played a myriad of parts in a career spanning over 40 years, Robert Stevens.
I can't decide at what point I thought I would like to be an actor.
At 10 to 11 on BBC One, the curtain rises as Robert Stevens takes on the great Shakespearean challenge, King Lear. Omnibus on Tuesday.
Cricket now on BBC One, and with highlights of the first of two one-day internationals between England and New Zealand, is Tony Lewis.